And coach, another season. Here we are, man. Baseball year, year 14 going into it. It's crazy to think how fast we've gotten back to it.
That's the understatement of the morning. I feel like I just got here, and it's already the 14th year. But what a joy it's been, and a privilege to be the baseball coach at LSU, Jordy. We've had some awesome kids throughout the years, and you know, had some success, and just the enthusiasm of the fans makes it a special place.
Fired up about your roster and able to see your pitching staff go this year. But let's start with a position guy in Daniel Cabrera, who's named to a preseason All-American team yesterday. Going into his third year, he'll wear number 8 for you this season. What's the expectation for Cabrera in year 3?
Yeah, you know, Daniel has so much talent. I don't even know if he realizes how good that he potentially can be. And if he just can do the things that he normally does and just do them on a little bit more consistent basis, he's going to have a bang-up year for us. Last year, people think he had a down year, and he hit like 12 home runs, you know, hit 280. But that's what happens when you have talent and people have high expectations of you. You know, it's never seems to be enough. But we all know he's better than that. And, you know, he went to the Cape this summer instead of playing for Team USA, which I thought was important for him to just get into the routine of playing every day and kind of figuring out his swing and what it takes each day. And I think he's better, and I think he'll have his best year this year.
Speaking of coach, we just talked about how long you now been at LSU. You've had a lot of different staffs, a lot of different teams. Where did this pitching staff rank? Is this the best kind of total staff that you've maybe ever had?
Well, that's a good question, and I'd like to give you an answer, but let's see how it plays out first. You know, you hate to compare teams, you know, from different years and so forth. What we've had in the past, of course, is really great pitcher at the top, and an Aaron Nola, an Alex Lang, a Kevin Gausman, an Anthony Renato. But one thing we've lacked for, it seems forever, is that depth to be able to go 10 deep. And that affects a lot of things. You know, if things aren't going so great in a particular game and you don't want to utilize your top relief pitchers, you want to be able to still be competitive in the game. And some years, you know, we've had to go to guys and then the game gets out of hand and everybody gets all upset. And, it's only one game, but it just seems worse than that. So I'm hoping that we're going to have a staff that we can go about 10 deep with the degree of confidence that they can keep us in games and hopefully rally if we're behind. But also, the key for us is still going to be, do we have a dominant guy at the very top? Because, you know, you look at the SEC, and every team has a first-round draft choice going on Friday night. And if you want to be able to compete on Friday night, you better be able to hold the other team to a low-run game. And I think Cole Henry has very much that capability of doing that. And, you know, unfortunately, he just, his freshman year last year, couldn't stay healthy all the time. But when he did pitch, It was special, you know, 12 strikeouts against Florida in five innings and seven innings of shutout at Georgia and so forth. So I have all the confidence in the world that Cole is going to stay healthy this year, that he's going to take it to another level and give us that great Friday night start. And then when you look at Saturday and Sunday with Marceau and Labus, I think that's about as solid as you can possibly hope to have.
To Coach's point, the depth is real this year. You mentioned the health, though, Coach, and I know that was a huge point of emphasis for y'all in the offseason. You have the new, like, mechanic, you know, the biomechanics center doing all this preventative research. What's been on the return? What's been the return on the health side?
Well, so far this, you know, in the fall, it was amazing. Guys threw harder than they ever have. They stayed healthy and they pitched well. So, you know, I think we're learning some things that, you know, about, you know, you got to remember these young kids come to us having played a lot of baseball before they ever get here, thrown a lot of balls between high school and travel ball in the summer and showcases. And, you know, they all want to show their stuff to the pro scouts. And, you know, arm needs rest, you know, it needs recovery time. And sometimes they arrive here without having given their arm much of a chance to rest. And so, you know, many times the kids show up, unfortunately, already nicked up, already injured a little bit. So we've just had to modify somewhat the way that we're preparing these kids and giving them a lot more time rest and monitoring that, you know, what condition their arms are in through, like you said, you called biomechanics. Those words are so big for me, you know. I got to use Corey tells me it's called the MODIS sleeve, so I just say MODIS sleeve, you know. But whatever the data that comes out of that is telling him where each arm is health-wise, and then we modify what that person's throwing schedule is for that particular day. So far, it seems to be working. I don't know if it's a end-all thing, but so far it's working. Let's hope it continues.
So wait, is this a sleeve that the pitchers wear that has like little like chips in it or technology or something?
Exactly. And wow. You know, but it also is connected to our the game tracker up on the press box where we can get spin rates and all those other things. So if they're not wearing the sleeve in the game, Corey can still access the data that he needs to input into the computer, so we still get a virtual reading on where the kid's arms where his health is with his arm.
Coach, you and Coach Ogeron signed a tremendous athlete in Mo Hampton out of the Memphis area. He came in and became a really big player on the defensive side of the ball for LSU football in their national championship run, especially to the last month of the season. He was expected to kind of step in and be a contributor for you on day one. How has kind of his getting out of football into baseball shape gone, and what are your expectations for your true freshman?
Well, I don't know who expected him to step in on day one. That's an awfully big task for a kid. You know, it's not like he's going to play for the Little Sisters of the Poor here. You know, LSU is a highly ranked baseball team, and to not have played all fall, not played all summer, heck, he played last spring with a broken wrist in high school. You know, to expect him to step in from day one and start hitting pitchers like Cole Henry and Landon Mars, who I think is a little bit unreasonable. But I've watched him now for almost 2 weeks with the individual workouts, and now we've had a week of practice. I see him getting better every day. You know, the swing is loosening up. He's such a great athlete. But, you know, he was a little stiff his first few days, not using his lower body in his swing. His confidence, you know, is not great. The ball looks like an aspirin to him coming in there, as you might imagine. Yeah. But the last couple of days, all of a sudden, he's starting to get it a little bit, and you hit a couple balls hard yesterday. Yeah, I think he had struck out like six straight times to start with, which did not surprise me one iota. Mikey Matuk once struck out 10 straight times in this preseason. So I told Mo, look, you got a way to go to catch Matuk, so don't worry about it, okay? But, you know, yesterday he hit a couple balls hard, and he's starting his judgment in the outfield, is starting to get a little bit better. You know, he's an athlete, man. He's a great kid. He's so dedicated to baseball. I don't know what the final result is going to be, where he gets to, but nothing he does would surprise me, and we'll just see how it plays out.
Coach Mainieri, you know me as a proud man of my Italian heritage. The last time you were on, or one of the last times you were on, it was a low point for me as we were talking about one of your players.
How great is the name Giovanni Diacabo?
It's a bad spot for me, Coach.
See, so when you talk about Mo, you got to talk about Giovanni DiGiacomo as
right.
Well now. Come on.
That's right. So let me follow up with my Sicilian brethren. How has Giovanni DiGiacomo's offseason been in year two for him?
For the Louisianans here that don't speak Italian, Gio would suffice, okay? Gio, you know, so Gio is a real interesting guy. You know, he reminds us a lot of players of the past like Mark Laird. He's got the same frame, you know, lanky, and he can fly lefty-lefty. His outfield play has improved dramatically, and I think his hitting has improved, but it's still not quite where you want it to be. He just needs to take advantage of his speed. You know, everybody wants to hit a ball out of the ballpark, but for every ball he hits out of the ballpark, he hits 50 fly ball outs and doesn't take advantage of his speed. So we're trying to get him to utilize that more, like kind of like Andrew Stevenson. When he got here, he wanted to hit the ball out of the park. Once he realized that God gave him a great asset with world-class speed, and he started putting the ball on the ground a little bit more, and all of a sudden he hit 360 and made it to the big leagues. So I'm hoping that Gio will make that transition. And, you know, like we've talked about Mo, you know, we got two guys there that are kind of projects for us, but the ceiling is so enormous that you just hope that they can fulfill it.
One more, Coach. People curious inside the huddle, Jaden Hill. What's your expectation on him?
I'm really excited about Jaden. Yeah, he's probably got as good arm as Cole Henry, if not better. He goes out there and throws 94, 95 miles an hour when he's feeling good. You know, just got to make sure he's feeling good, and we got to do it with baby steps with him. If we try to ask too much of him, which is a great temptation, then it sets it back. You know, so we just got to take it slow. Let this kid pitch a while, short outings. Can continue to gain confidence, continue to believe that he's going to be healthy, continue to keep him healthy, And then maybe his role expands as the season goes on, as we need him maybe a little bit more. But initially, I want to use him out of the bullpen. Hey, what an asset to come out of the bullpen throwing 94-95, the great changeup and breaking ball and intimidating presence out there.
Just a little over 2 weeks from now, LSU will kick off their season February 14th. That's Friday, February 14th at the box, 7 o'clock first pitch with Coach Paul Mainieri in year 14 in the Tigers, again in the top 15. Coach, thanks for the time this morning, and good luck this season.